Historically, banks generated most of their income from the differential between interest income earned and interest expenses. In recent years, this business model has shifted across the Caribbean and wider afield, and there's now greater emphasis on fee income. Rationales often offered include the high regulatory costs of compliance and the need to recover costs associated with investment in technology. In addition, some charges are predicated on moving customers away from non-electronic modes of banking. And therefore, I think some of the banks are trying to discourage persons from using the banking hall and to use the ATM into which much of the investment has been placed. Now, Barbadians have not traditionally been avid investors. Instead, most persons have opted to place the money in savings account and to let it earn interest. But now account holders are confronted with charges associated with maintaining an account. The ATM fees, the teller fees, the minimum balance fees, the paper statement fees, large value withdrawal fees, and monthly service charges, just to name a few. These fees in the current low interest rate environment create the risk that some persons may be charged more for maintaining an account than they are earning from it. We could then be faced with a situation where persons withdraw from the financial system either because they literally cannot afford to have a bank account or because they are not willing, as we've heard them say, to, and I quote, pay the banks to keep their money. In 2008, the central bank issued guidance to the sector on certain charges in recognition that it is difficult to control all of the charges instituted by these institutions. The industry is largely compliant with these requirements. But in the interim, new charges have arisen, an inherent weakness in trying to maintain price controls. Mindful of the risk, however, we believe that we must, at a minimum, seek to safeguard the interests of small account holders. And we are looking at precedents set in other Commonwealth countries for addressing this precise problem. We expect to update our guidance shortly to industry. In addition, it is our intention to publish on our website key fees and charges of the respective institutions as is done in several of our regional counterparts, as customers need to be aware of their options when conducting transactions.